there is a good chance you want to make a positive change in your life. You're always looking for advice and you're open to it, but you always hear the most common pieces of advice consistently, but there always seems to be something wrong with it. This is advice such as don't worry about what people think and believe in yourself. But what is wrong with the most common pieces of advice? Well, the good things about it is that it is common advice for a reason, because they must work or have worked a lot in the past. People who follow these most common pieces of advice are always doing very well from themselves and always reiterate these pieces of advice. But that's the first biggest problem. You do have to follow the advice. It would be great if you hear advice and you could just follow it right away. Usually people giving the advice with no practical steps and how to achieve the results the advice is trying to achieve. There's nothing wrong with the advice itself, because people who are giving it have the best intentions in their heart and they know it's right and they want you to succeed with it, and they're telling you this because they know it's the right thing to do. We've all done it where someone asks for advice and you've probably said some of these common answers. Even super simple answers such as, hey, that's great, or hey, wow, you're really getting better. There's still so many questions in it, such as how are they getting better? What is actually better? How can I continue to be better? There's so many good intentions behind it, but there's still some questions. The most successful self-help gurus out there, those gurus tend to have a plan in order to enact those most common pieces of advice. So what I'm gonna do is I'm gonna try to take the three most common pieces of advice that if you could follow it, you would probably have a more adventurous life, and try to give you simple steps in order to start achieving the results it is supposed to do. I am not a self-help expert, just someone who's passionate about having an adventurous life and always improving myself, and I wanna share that with you. Speaking about people, most common advice number one is don't care about what people think. That is a difficult one for sure, because we have grown up to be drilled in our heads that we need to care about what people think, even if you don't realize it. We grew up needing the approval of our parents, our teachers, our coaches, our bosses, our friends, our peers. For most of us, our identity, who we see ourselves or who we think we are, is strongly connected to how people see us. What this advice is trying to do is change your perceived identity into programmed identity and self-identity. It's who you want to be and how you should see yourself. This advice probably isn't followed because a combination of being afraid of failure or what people will think and how people won't accept your decisions or actions. What if there was a simple way to start this process and spread some good and joy in the world? Just try complimenting complete strangers. You've probably seen someone with a really cool jacket or really nice shoes or even just a beautiful shirt. Just taking a couple of seconds to tell someone that you think their hat is very cute or looks really nice is such a good feeling for them. If you've ever had this happen to you, you know that feeling of a simple gesture of kindness and goodness. It goes a long way and it sticks with you. Someone compliment me in my Batman shirt and for whatever reason, I still remember that. Not only that, but you're getting used to stepping outside your comfort zone and just saying and doing things that you actually think and feel. Yes, this is a very simple way of doing this, and there are multiple steps after this that you can build off of it, but it's just creating some goodness in the world and allowing you to step outside your comfort zone without worrying what people think. And that is another second biggest piece of advice that people tell you, and that is to step outside your comfort zone. This is another one that you probably don't do because we are afraid of failure. What stepping outside your comfort zone is trying to get you to do is to not be afraid of being afraid. We have a comfort zone for a reason, because that is our safe space. That is where we are comfortable, because if we're stressed the entire time and never comfortable, that's not good for your health. However, being in that comfort zone for too long is dangerous, as you get complacent and just bored. My last video that you can see right here talks about boredom and gives simple steps on how to change a boring day. talks a lot more about boredom and what it is, and I strongly suggest watching that video. It takes this small piece of advice and expands on it a little bit more and gives you a perspective that takes a little bit more time. But for this video, the main thing you need to take is to make a habit about being uncomfortable. Just like anything, it takes practice. And the more practice you put into it, the better you are going to get. Our goal is to practice stepping outside your comfort zone. Most of the adventures I've done on these videos on the channel have really allowed me to step outside my comfort zone because there are things that I would have never done, such as scuba diving and kiteboarding. But there are simpler ones that you can do right now, such as waking up in the morning early or simply meditating every single day. When I first started hearing about this advice about stepping outside your comfort zone, I always thought I had to do these big and grand gestures and activities in order to really step outside my comfort zone. That's not how everyone works. Some people are like that. Others need to take these smaller approaches. Doing something that is outside your comfort zone every single day for 10 minutes is easy to do. You can see how it went when I tried meditating every single day, but you can pick a skill that you want because if you actually want to do it, you'll be more motivated to stick to it. Something such as learning music, grab a guitar, pluck those strings, and create some tunes. You should aim for doing something for 10 minutes every single day just for a week. There is no point of aiming big if it's not achievable. There is nothing wrong with trying to aim for the moon. There is something wrong with not knowing how to build a rocket ship. If you achieve doing that thing for a week, then you can let the snowball effect take place or just choose a new skill so that you are always learning. Either way, I know it's achievable and you can do it. All you have to do is believe in yourself. The third most common advice I want to tackle. In fact, you should believe in yourself. Humans and people are capable of amazing things. Look at the past and the present and see the amazing things that people have done and are doing every single day. And I know you can do it as well. You have proven it to yourself before, but sometimes you just don't believe it or you just don't know how to. There's a TEDx talk that I'm gonna put in a link in the description below about a man named Jim Cathcart that really put it into perspective and separated believing yourself into three phases. First is respecting your nature. There are generations leading up to where you are right now. You are not a singular being stuck in this situation alone. There are building blocks and foundations that have been built from people before you to set you up for where you are right now. Just simple technologies such as the internet allow you to do certain things that the past just weren't able to do. And if you can respect and understand everything that has gone before you, that everything that you do is off the backs of giants, it really puts your actions in perspective. And anything you accomplish is going to set up future generations. The second is to know your nature, really know yourself. How can you believe in yourself or how can you apply yourself if you don't even understand yourself? Every single person is different and is unique. If you can really learn and understand who you are, you will be able to apply yourself and know where you need to be to succeed. That means knowing what you really care about, knowing your patterns and how you behave in certain situations. What are the things that you are smart in, your style, your motives and your beliefs? The more you can understand you, the better you'll be at being a better version of you. This can be done through meditation, journaling your thoughts and feelings, writing them down, speaking them out, whatever is the best process for you to process. And lastly, you have to apply your nature, which is just applying the things that you are capable of. Out of all the steps, this is obviously the hardest part, but the TEDx video put perspective and numbers behind it. He talks about a story listening to Earl Nightingale, who was the Tony Robbins of the past, and explains how if you just spent one extra hour every single day, you could become a national expert in that subject in less than 5 years. Now, really think about that and really let that set in. You could become a national expert in anything, whatever you want, in less than 5 years by spending one extra hour every single day. Jim Cathcart explains on how he heard that and how he took that advice and he became an expert in his field of human development. So what do you want to be an expert in? It's going to take time and a little bit of effort in realizing that it's not going to happen overnight, and that it is something you need to accept, but one day you're going to wake up and you'll be where you want to be because you believed in yourself. And it starts by realizing that it is possible. And if you're looking for other adventures, there are links down below to Groupon and Airbnb, which is where I find most of my adventures. But that's my experience. What do you think? What are the most common advice that you have heard that's really changed your life? Because sometimes it just takes a couple of words to really allow you to be focused on what you really want. Let me know down in the comments below. You can always hit me up on social media, and I will be with you at the next adventure.